most countries don't allow you the opportunity to be able to compete at a high level and get educated at a high level. And again, that's another unique opportunity that we have here in the States that, you know, we may take for granted at times and not realize how lucky we are to have that.
When we looked into the American system, you could play sport at a very high level and you could study at a very high level. Then there was no better option than to come here and pursue a dream and also get an education at the same time.
It was just something that he always wanted to do. It was just, this was his dream, and he wanted an education, but he wanted to play soccer.
You can't be an elite athlete at home and be a top academic student. You have to make a choice.
That, you know, there are opportunities for young people out there to balance education and soccer, and America, you know, provides that opportunity that not any other country in the world provides.
And while that opportunity is unique, recruiting these players has its own challenges.
Every international player has a different path that they're going down, and it's a different recruiting strategy, and it's a different, you know, process altogether.
But yeah, with Eric, we had three conversations. He was very personable. He was very eager to help me as a person, I guess, like individually.
The internet has made it a lot easier from both the player perspective and the coach's perspective. They can get the research Quinnipiac, look at the videos, take the virtual tour. They can check up on the coach. They'll see if anyone knows them.
I think a big factor was Dave's an Irishman, so I kind of had some roots there. And just from there, I was just pumped, and I was ready to just take a new step in my life and see where the adventure leads me.
Adventures can be exciting. However, they can be a bit scary too.
Every day, just on Skype, upset with my parents, you know, I don't know if I can do this. It's tough. I don't know anyone.
A lot of the American kids have their parents a phone call away or a car ride away. And these people are, you know, miles and hours and oceans away. You know, so it's important to have that connection.
I knew he had a team around him. I knew he wasn't really here by himself. I knew he had a coach that I'd spoken to that promised to look after him. And we knew he'd be all right.
Opportunities don't come often for especially kids from New Zealand, to play sport overseas in a semi-professional environment, training every day and everything. So when you get opportunities, you got to take them, and you got to take them with an attitude to do something with it.
It's still a huge jump for any parents to say, I don't know this guy. They didn't know that they were going to be in a nice dorms and locations. There's a lot of horror stories because there are a lot of players who end up in bad locations and bad situations. Everything's not Quinnipiac. And you know the staff that we provide here, that we look after them on and off the field.
Sometimes you may be scared, you personally might be scared, your parents might be scared of what could happen to you, what might happen to you, but I think you're not going to know until you actually do it.
It was tough, but then as the homesickness passed, I changed major, which had a massive impact, and that's when it all started. I came back in the spring and I was home. It felt like home.
All right. The-